hopefully find solution to the killer herdsmen issues in Nigeria. And join me from Nigeria and around the world, I have Akin Fapohunda, who is the Secretary Steering Committee, Eminent Elders Forum, Dr. Jonathan Asake, the President, Southern Kaduna People's Union, Comrade Deli Ajufo, who is the Coordinator and Yoma Redemption Group, Lieutenant Colonel Tony Inyan, who was among the Gideon Oka group. Also, we will have Yinka Odumakin, who is the spokesperson of Afanifere, a social cultural organization of the Yoruba people of Nigeria. Dr. Sam Amadi, who is an associate professor and a former chairman of Nigerian Electricity Regulatory Commission. I have my good brother, Dr. Don Pedro Obaseke, former managing director at Dire Communication PLC and the current president general of the Midwest Movement. The Amazon in the house, Ankyo Briggs, the human rights and environmental rights activist. We have Chief Dele Mamodu, journalist, who is also the CEO and publisher of Evasion International. The last and not the least is Mr. Tabara Samuel, who is also a human rights activist.
It is not well with us here in Benue State, and what I can hear from others say, it is not well with Nigeria today. You must act fast before it is late.
As you have heard the governor there say, it is not well with Nigeria and it is not well with Nigerians. I will be bringing in my brother from the Midwest, as he always wants me to say, Dr. Don Pedro Obaseke.
I want to thank, first of all, I want to thank Mazi Ezeoke for this very important conference. For me, we all have a problem. Who we tell Mr. President? Nigeria is like a race on his knees. And I truly believe that as things so stand, particularly as it pertains to my people, the Midwestern people of Nigeria, the Edo and Delta peoples of Nigeria, the only legitimately created region of this country, whether we like it or not, it may not be nice to say, that every indication that the nation is a nation is a lie. Like Awolo once told us, Nigeria is a mere geographic expression. As Ahmadu Bello once told us, God did not create Nigeria, the British did. And as it is, who will tell the president that the house that was built on a pack of cards is crumbled? But all the indices went to a very crazy dynamo that Nigeria is dead. It's just a contraption, badly skewed and badly cobbled together, a mixture and not a compound, a country and not a nation. And it is beholding on all of us gathered here to begin to think about the strategic imperatives that will be required to save our people. When an Igbo man says in the bay, he's not thinking about the man in Karanamuda. He's thinking about the man in Isikwato, in Imo, in Ibitoli Kedro. So when the Benin man says Ibiebume, he's thinking about people from Edo and Delta. And that is the truth. Nothing in the last few years, particularly, seems to aid the continued existence of Nigeria. And not to say that is to be a little economical with the truth. Nigeria is an anomaly. Nigeria is the wimp and caprice of a man who sat behind the sanctuary of his locked door and legislated away the freedoms of our people. Nigeria has to be looked into properly, and all the federating units must be made to sit down and decide their continued marriage, this forced marriage. Either we divorce or we agree. But for us to continue to operate the 1999 Constitution, which was premised ab initio in the first page on a lie, we the people is a lie. I just remember the declaration in the United Nations of December the 7th, and then the one that was put together, I think it was led by the Lower Niger Congress, of December the 16th. We have to let the world know that our collective peoples are a people under serious decimation. Particularly now, the news coming out is about Edo State. We are the access to the sea, and we are a motley of 12 ethnic minorities, nations, that were in 1914, willed away and wished away. And we don't want that to continue. The headsman problem now had moved from Mr. Governor of Benue State, Mr. Tom, all those that have been driven away from Benue, they just crossed down, crossed into Lokoja and head towards our places. So the roads between Edo and Delta State have become valleys of death. We're not missing words about it. We shall defend our people. We are first the people within our people before we are Nigerians. I'm an Edo man, I'm a Bendelite, and then I'm a Nigerian. It's like saying I am Scottish, then I'm British. I cannot be Nigerian in vacuo I'm a Nigerian by accident, but I'm not an Edo man by accident. So we believe, when I saw the paper, the title of the conference, I said, this is good, but it is beyond the headsmen. The headsmen are actually repercussive of an endearing system that is built on crazy fault lines. And unless those fault lines are addressed, what we will just be doing is playing Russian roulette with a problem that will continue, albeit unabated. And that, I think, would be the nadir for this country. I don't know how long I will speak, but I can speak forever. It is important that all of us begin to confederate outside the Nigerian Federation as it is so presently constituted, and make sure that there is a dismantling of that faulty federation, and decide on the proper paradigm as is found everywhere in a normal federation on planet Earth. And then we can sit on the table just like our forefathers sat in 1958, in 1959, prior to the 1960 Constitution and the 1963 Constitution, and decide on what paradigms, on how we will federate. There should be a stop to the molestation of the Igbo. There must be a stop to the decimation of the backyards of the Yorubas. And there must be a stop, whether they like it or not, to the serial raping and murder of our people in Edo and Delta. And that is the truth. The Middle Belt will now serve as a buffer, so that they will know that the less than, they can give you any 10% full and 10%. They are not 10%. Please go back to the 2006 census. They are less than 6.35%. If you are able to separate the Fulani from the Hausas. Now they no longer mention Hausa Fulani. They say Fulani, because the Hausas ab initio are their selves. They are their slaves. The Edo man, the Urobo man, the Isoko man, the Izo man, the Esako man. We are not slaves to anybody. We are bona fide indigenous persons who inhabit our space. The Ijo man is not a slave to anybody. They are the traditional owners of their space. And taking into consideration one of the last acts that was done by Kofi Annan before he left, may so rest in peace. And I think I can see Tonenandi here, somewhere here. And that is what we must look at. Nigerians must educate ourselves so that we know where the loopholes are in this constitution, take it down, and then put in place a proper engaging paradigm that will help us move forward this nation, if indeed we want a nation. Outside of that, we are just marking time. You know, as the Yoruba say, it is when the wind blows that we see the anus of the fowl. Right now, the Nigerian fowl is a featherless bonbon, and that is the truth. And to continue to want to engage, find ways, placate, and it will not work. The Yoruba persons know they are historical victims, right from the days of Afonja and the invasion of Alimi in Ilori, of this. And we will not, as a people, we are sending this one to everybody. We are small. But Biniman say, Ehiendo Kama Uzaze, don't underrate the potency of the alligator pepper. And that is the truth. The people of Edo and Delta, the larger persons of the Niger Delta, all of us, we are ready, as it is now, to save first our people before we begin to talk about other, let me use this very funny word, cross-border handshakes with any of those other persons who inhabit the Nigerian country. It is not a nation. A nation never dies. Nigeria never attained nationhood. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Dr. Don Pedro Abaseke. You know, summarizing what you've just said, it's very simple that in your view, in order for us to make progress, we must dismantle the faulty federation. That the 1963 Constitution should be a baseline template to move forward. Now, I have to bring Dr. Don Pedro Abaseke quickly back. Dr. Don Pedro Abaseke, if you're able to do your closing remarks and in 2 or 3 minutes,
I will do that. I thank God for, I'm happy that to hear everything we've all been saying. And quickly, I want to just say this quickly. I drafted a few things here. Previously, a couple of days ago, I wrote to members of our Midwest movement, which we've been trying to circulate, and I will just read it out. And maybe that will form a kind of submission of what is actually going down. I said, we have before us a dead country. A nation never dies, and Nigeria never attained nationhood. We have a decomposing body in search of its undertakers. What manner of entombment? Those are the bullet points of a future discourse of what was once a nation. You see, prior to independence, in 1959, Soyinka wrote a piece, he called it A Dance of the Forest. And there was the endearing one liner that Nigeria was a nation born dead. And one of my friends, a very astute Midwesterner, Ogaga Ifowodu, actually reminded me of those exact lines. That I, whose mother is dead, I feel this dread. I feel this dread that I will be born dead. Nigeria is born dead. We are in what the Middle Ages used to call memento mori. We are in a macabre dance of death, the dance of death. Somebody mentioned Tony Nandi. Tony Nandi, and a few of us had, as far back as December, as far back as 2007, actually gave through the United Nations a pathway for each of us to actually assert our nationhood without letting them kill us even before we start trying to arm ourselves. Because we are indigenous peoples in our space. And as such, we have a right to self-determination, which includes whether to federate or not. And Akin Bakunda has just explained it in a very simple way. And Yankee mentioned it. I am an Edo. I am a Midwesterner. Before, I'm a Nigerian. And the 1963 Constitution, which had actually split Nigeria politically and fiscally, not fiscally, it's fiscally. We all forget that everything about the Federation is about resource control. And that is clear. We all forget that once upon a time in this country, the revenue allocation formula was 50-30-20, where 50% was resident in the federating units. So Awolowo can give all Westerners free education. So Cocoa House can be built. And then 30% is resident and shared pro rata by all the federating units, and 20% with the federal government. Nigeria today is a country operating via reverse osmosis. Now, on December 13th or December 16th, there was a union dispute that was raised. And that was a joint proclamation to announce that Nigeria is dead. So what we are just doing, what Buhari is doing, what the Hausa Fulani is doing, is just playing roulette. Nigeria is dead. So I want to plead all of us to go back to what both Aki and Onkuyinka have said earlier. We have to form a strategic bind. We have to forego our personals so that we see the corporate, so that we can put in the forefront the needs and aspirations of our people, of the Ijaw nation, of the Yorobo nation, of the Shekiri nation, of the Enoani peoples, of everybody, either you are from Isikwato, whether you are from Nemo. We must put those things in. We must understand that the Fulani historically, if you have a historiographic approach, you will understand that what we are facing now is just a recourse of history playing itself back again. And as a result of that, the only way we can nip this in the bud is for us to form a strategic plate where, for the first time, the Nigerian federating units will begin to talk as one. If not, we are just on a bad journey to Neverland, and they will decimate us by picking us one after the other and giving our rogue political class one little title or the other, while the wretched of our earth continue to die. Now, we must take a stand. When you sit on the fence, life will pass you by on both sides. I refuse to sit on the fence. The Edo and Delta people, the Enoani people, the Anioma people, the Akoko Edo, Esako, Bini, Urobo, Isoko, Ijaw people, we will not sit on the fence. We will not be cannon fodder for any marauding Fulani herdsmen. Nobody teaches anybody how to pull the trigger. And that is the truth. And the Nigerian nation does not have the capacity to fight wars on more than one front. They've been fighting uneducated, illiterate bandits since the year 2010, and they have not succeeded. If we, the people of Edo, Delta, Ekiti, with this largest number of professors, sit down and arrange a paradigm to liberate our people, the Nigerian nation, with its 335,000 security force, cannot face us. God bless all of us while we think of how to liberate our people. Patode, na good night.
Thank you.